Large language models, aka Mr. LLMs, have gotten a new friend that makes them 90% more powerful. This new friend is called Retrieval-Augmented Generation, aka Mr. RAG. Today, we are going to discuss about what RAG is and how it's making large language models more useful in today's tech world. Ready to do it? Let's get right into it and learn all you need to know about RAG. So right before we learn what RAG is, let's reverse the clock back to large language models and see how they work. So in the diagram here, this is your large language model. This can be GPT, Llama, or any of the large language models. Okay. So large language models accept inputs or prompts, and then based on the given prompt, they give you a desired output. So for instance, let's say you ask this large language model, what is science? It will take this as a test and process it and then give you an output. Okay, science is dot 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 and dot dot dot. And that's how they work. But they have some couple of problems. Let's say, for instance, I asked GPT, who is the current president of United States or USA? You can see the answer it gives me. As of my last update in January 2022, I can't provide real-time information, but you can easily find out by checking the latest news or a reliable online source. So you can see they have knowledge cut off right at the day they were trained and deployed for us to use. And this is a problem because maybe you still need the latest information. But sorry to say, large language models cannot provide you with the current information. They can only provide you information up to the day they were trained and deployed. And this is the problem the new friend called Retrieval Augmented Generation is solving for LLM, making them much powerful, making them to get access to current information. And let's now dive into it and look at how RAG works. So with RAG, how it works is that it will take your user input or query or your user prompt, and before sending this user prompt to the LLM, it has to first go into your database. That means with RAG, you can provide additional source of information. This source of information can be PDFs, can be the internet, can be Wikipedia, which is one reliable source where you can get information, can be unstructured data, can be TXT files or whatever, any source of information you have. It can also be your company's database where you can connect to these large language models for it to work hand in hand. So let's say, for instance, I ask this same question by using RAG. First, my query will be like, who is the current US president? This query will first go into data sources and search for relevant current information about whom the current US president is, and then we'll return this back to the LLM together with my question, and then the LLM will now go ahead to generate me a response. So let's take this once again. I asked this LLM, okay, who is the current president of the United States? It will first send this and search into my data source. And I said this data source can be your database, company database. It can be PDF files. It can be the internet. You can connect the whole internet to an LLM. And then search for relevant text. So it will search for relevant text that correlate to the question that you are asking. And after getting those relevant information, it will bring that relevant information back together with your query or your question you've asked and send it to the LLM. And the LLM will generate you a response based on the data it has gotten from your data source. So this makes LLMs to stay current, to stay updated, and also answer questions based on context, not just giving you random answers from anywhere at all. So this will, one way or the other, make LLMs trustworthy to use, because at the end of the day, you can validate it easily because you've connected it to your own data and you have idea or knowledge about how your data looks like. So this is all you need to know about RAG, or Retrieval Augmented Generation. And in a nutshell, what RAG is helping you achieve is that it gives you that freedom to connect to different data sources, being it your database, PDF files, TXT files, and so many other data sources you could even think of. So it helps you not to depend on answers coming from large language models only, because answers provided by large language models can sometimes be incorrect or even inconsistent in the answers it gives you. So RAG is playing a major role, and that's why it's one of the hottest topics in the tech industry right now. So as usual, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, make sure you leave it under the comment section and I'll be glad to attend to your question. Also like and share to anyone you think might also benefit from this. Thanks for watching once again, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.